You do. You sound excellent.
Okay, I'm recording right now.
How do I sound? Do I sound like my normal self, or do I sound
You sound a little muted, I would say, is the right word. Like a little, your dynamic range is lower.
Yeah, well, I'm using my earbuds.
Yeah.
Just to cut down on any background noise, but I have this other recording of this other camera.
Okay, perfect.
And if I put it through the ringer, it might come out better. It's great. So, what are you drinking, Andrew? Do you have your beverage?
I'm going to record to the cloud. Here we go. Message is being recorded. All right. Okay. What am I drinking, Andrew Bauman? I am drinking ginger soda.
Hey, Rob. Hey, Rob is drinking a cider, a non-alcoholic cider, but I will have a beer shortly. I have to hit okay. Okay. I'm...
Okay, hey, hold Rob on, Rob. I'm going to get myself a beverage.
Arizona is a wildly beautiful place, brimming with over 100 brewing companies. I'm Rob Fulmer, the Executive Director of the Arizona Craft Brewers Guild. I'm joined by Deputy Director Andrew Bauman. Together we cover the state, bringing you the best of what's happening at our breweries and beyond. Welcome to Arizona Beer Frontier.
So since I can't have my computer in front of me and also have a microphone in front of me, I had to put a microphone arm over from the chair because obviously we can't clamp anything to this table. It's pretty cool.
I know.
It's pretty neat.
We are the unclampable.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's still, it's very, very janky, but it's working.
Yeah, well, you ought to see what this looks like on the backside here, let me tell you. I got every piece of equipment out of my bag. It's just sitting here, you know.
As happens, sure, I've seen you.
I've got to get the red tint out of this because everything's under a red umbrella.
True. I mean,
this is supposed
to
be black and white.
Yeah. No, wow. Hey, hey, Rob.
Andrew Bauman, what are you drinking?
I got myself a Copper State IPA from Huss Brewing Company.
Oh, I set aside some beverages for you. Do you not recall?
I did. Actually, I took one home yesterday. I did my stuff early, and then I went and watched Dead Men Don't Wear Plaid with my father. And we shared one of the... beers from Smeltertown. I have the other one though, which I'm saving for us like when you're back, because it's a lager.
Okay, I can already tell that we're gonna have to just use the Zoom as a reference because you dropped out a little bit there, so not a big deal because we have backups at fail safe soon. Anyway,
we have backups.
I'm having a non-alcoholic cider. It is from Cosmic Apples, which you can get everywhere in America these days now, but that was the pride of the Pike Market, I guess. And this is with lavender, which they also grow here. So a lavender, very nice cider. I've actually had a couple ciders on this trip. So
sounds great.
But I did set aside some beverage from you because I stopped at Smeltertown before I left. For Seattle, and we should probably talk about
where you're sitting.
The grand opening. Well, no, we should just start from the start, which is Friday.
Friday.
Thursday, I drove up to Flagstaff to bring our equipment from Baja Beer Fest from Tucson all the way up to Flagstaff because it's been sitting in my car for an entire month, for a week.
That is a long time.
I drove up.
You can sit out here, enjoy life.
I'm sorry, there's a tour going by here. I'm being distracted. I drove up put some posters down for our big event, Real Wild and Woody. And I don't remember if it was on the way up or on the way back. You told me that Vulture Peak Brewing in Wickenburg was going to be open.
They open at 3:00 on Friday.
Yeah, so I was like, I'll be there. I'll be there. But as it turns out, I was there like at 6:00, not 3:00, because I went with some intention to the new Sedona Base Camp tap room. It is closer to, well, it's on the side of town that Coffee Pot Road, Oak Creek tap room and brewery is. If you're only familiar with the Tlacopaki restaurant, there's another brewery in Oak Creek. So it's on, I guess that would be the west side of town. It's closer to the wineries out that way.
And definitely off and that main tourist strip.
Right, and it's, 15, 20 minutes from Cottonwood. But anyway, it's a beautiful patio. It's got a nice tap room. Super modern looking, but with lots of rock features. I'll throw some pictures up on the video if you're watching it on the video. They did a really good job on that. They have, in fact, they have apple trees that they're trying to cultivate in the shade. So
cool.
And that's a part of the country that can support it, Sedona area, because they do get cold enough for the tree to go dormant. And then I went to Smeltertown and talked to Alan, with the owners. They said they had a spectacular March, super busy. They have a festival coming up, I think this weekend, the 18th maybe. There was a wine festival in town too last weekend. But I picked up those two beers. One was a IPA that was a collaboration with Ash. Is that the one you took home?
Yes, it was delicious.
So I got two beers. I got one that was your beer, kind of beer.
Yeah.
And I got one that was more my kind of beer, even though... I would love a Pilsner.
Okay, I do need to grab a credit card.
Oh, yeah,
so
absolutely.
So I can open a tab up, my friend. Appreciate it.
Come on, little boy.
Thank you.
See, this is what some states do. Everyone gets ID'd.
Right now?
Yeah.
No, any food or anything else for you?
The Pilsner would be great for now.
Cool.
And I'll just wave and keep them coming. So I got a Pilsner for myself, even though I knew I wasn't going to be there. So I got the beer that you would enjoy, and I got a beer that I would enjoy, even though I knew I wasn't going to be there. So I thought you would have it here. But the Ash IPA, it was brewed by two Ash members. One was named John. The other one was named Wayne. And Alan, you know Alan, right?
Yes.
I don't want to be... sexist or anything, but like, she's a petite little flower, right? I mean, she runs that tap room, you know, like a boss. But she's like, I wanted to call it John Wayne Gacy Hazy.
Oh God.
Or something like that.
That's something people Gacy's can do, sure.
Gacy's Hazy. That's what she wanted to name it, because they were named John and Wayne. And I'm like, yeah.
Doing a different name is better. Speaking of that pro-am you're talking about, that's part of my little weekend, but we're not there yet.
Oh, okay. Well, then you can pick it up, because you were already by this time at Vulture Peak, and then I was there probably an hour after you left, maybe more. So
probably more. Yeah.
You drove on up.
Yeah, I headed up to, I left here about 1 to head to Wickenburg, and 1:00 on Friday, I thought was going to be a pretty easy drive, but That was not the case at all. It was a disaster the whole way. I thought I was going to miss you, honestly. I was like, he's going to be there at 3, and I'm going to get there at like 4 with this traffic. But indeed, I got there at 3:02. So it did take 2 hours, which is a lot longer than normal, but I built in some little time, just like Ida Stedman, my orchestra teacher, taught me.
Yeah.
If you're late, you're dead. So wow. I didn't have to die. It was great. However, when I got there at 3 for the grand opening, it was packed. I mean, it was completely busting out the doors.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a small tap room. And we should explain that we had toured maybe a couple times the location that they originally wanted to be, which is Kitty Corner across the street from where we hold Wickenburg Oktoberfest. And, you know, it had a nice area between some buildings, but we shouldn't really pump that up too much because that kind of all fell through due to the landlord not really wanting to put power on the building something to that effect.
Yeah.
So they had to relocate, and I said, congratulations. No, a lot of businesses would not survive that.
A lot of them would have just said, never mind, I'm out of here.
Right. But they persevered, and I heard that you gave the speech, and I saw the sign presented.
I did give the speech. We took some pictures. We didn't get a video, and they were so busy. Here's the thing about a busy brewery. It doesn't get slower if you interrupt them for 30 seconds. It's just the same amount of busy. Just push back 30 seconds. That's all. So, like... Yeah, it was very cute. The dad, the owner, Bryce? Shoot. He was there. Son.
Yep.
And then the two grandsons were doing some bussing tables and washing dishes, and they're like 13 and 15. And it was just the cutest thing.
Yeah, that was still happening when I was there.
The whole town came out to cheer him on. They had two food trucks. It was great.
Yeah, it is a smaller place than they had wanted, but the important thing is they're making beer, and they have the community support, and they will grow together. If you're intending on going, for a while it might be packed. There's not a lot of seating, and they weren't able to get their extension of premise. They're permanent. They want to do a permanent patio structure. And they weren't able to get the temporary, so might be a little bit before things sort of settle down to whatever's regular, but it's a good problem to have, right?
They opened with at least 10 beers on draft.
Yeah. So that was cool. They already had 5 or 6 in the works. So
they sent me a picture of our guild sign posted. It's right between the window looking at the brewery and the door into the brewery. And sent me a picture and said, now it's officially official. Thought that was nice. Oh boy. Where are you, Rob?
I'm at Old Stove Brewing, and they have several locations. This is right next to Pike Market. It's right on the water. I can see a Ferris wheel. I can see shipping. I'll just throw some B-roll up. I could see both the stadiums. I could see I think it's Mount Rainier, snow peaked. There's some snow on the Cascades behind me. It's quite a scene. These tables are public tables, but they can serve beer on them. So that's why I was able to sort of camp out here before they opened. So it's a great joint. I'm gonna adjust this camera.
Lovely.
I guess, did you do anything else over the weekend?
I left Wickenburg, headed back down to my home in Chandler, and I stopped at 8-Bit Brewing, said hi to them.
Yep.
That was fun. It's great to get out there and see the new cool stuff they got going on. And then, headed back home and Saturday was a whirlwind. Went to Fibber McGee's in the morning to watch the Tottenham Hotspurs beat Burnley, who just got relegated. Oh, geez. Poor Burnley.
It sounds like they beat up an individual.
Yeah.
That sounds like a guy, person.
They're out of the league now. That's such a bummer.
Oh.
But that was cool. I had a Guinness 0.0, as one does at 7 o'clock in the morning when you want beer, but you have a long day. Then Bonnie took an Uber over and met me there, and we headed over to the Ash Clubhouse. At the Ash Clubhouse, they were doing the Pro-Am judging. They had three tables with four judges each, judging homebrewer and pro-brewer collaboration beers.
Nice.
Yeah. Got a.
I suppose you spun him up on our competition. Got him all excited about.
Got him all excited. Gave him a little bit of swag, you know, as one does. They have their. Is it a dinner tonight? Is it just an awards thing? I'm not sure. That clubhouse is looking swanky.
It is. It is. And it's super affordable to be a member, even if you just a booster, even if you are homebrew adjacent.
I tell you what, they support all the breweries so much. Membership is a trivial amount of money, but they did say that their biggest benefactor is none other than John Lane of Oso fame. That he makes personal visits and says, hey, what do you guys need? And they're like, oh, we don't need anything. Thanks for all your support. Well, he says, well, here's a check. And they're hoping to create the entire area to become air conditioned. Lease time is up. It's time for them to renew their lease in a year. So,
yeah. Yeah.
Just like everybody, I guess.
Yeah, and they also have Oro's water system, and I can't remember whose mill they have from a brewery. And they also recently acquired a two-head bottling line from Saddle Mountain, I think. I should say it's not a bottling line, it's more of a bottling station. Bottling's kind of fell out of favor, but it's still a great way to get competition samples out. It's the preferred method for a lot of brewers, even if they have canning lines. People like Derek Osborne, Doc. So.
Yes.
So I said, you should keep that. And also, there's still plenty of people making wedding beers, and those just seem to sing differently in a bottle, right?
Well, I mean, there are homebrewers that have an October machine and can get blanks and seam their own cans and get their beer in cans. But for the majority, a bottle is just an easy way to put stuff in a portable package.
Yeah, and you're not going to get the oxygen pickup with the longer neck, especially if you foam on the top. It's a little harder to do it.
Right.
But we're kind of in the weeds here.
Yeah?
That is our nature. Saturday, I just did a bunch of errands. I didn't leave for Seattle until Saturday night.
It is our pleasure to welcome you to Seattle Tacoma International Airport. The local time is 12:07 a.m.
We did not enjoy any Aurora Borealis, so.
Oh man, was it cloudy? What happened?
It just wasn't. I think the day was Saturday. Sunday there was a chance, but you know it could be. If you watch the radar, it could be for 10 minutes, you know, in a window of 4 hours. So, you know, it's that
really
unpredictable.
Huh. Yeah, I didn't really realize that. We went out on Saturday night and Sunday night. There was no goods. There's too much ambient light.
Yeah, yeah. Well, yeah, we would have had to seen it from the airplane, or once we landed, we would have had to have a plan, and that was going to happen. So, Sunday, we're here, and it's Mother's Day, so we're very close to this market here, and it's a big tourist attraction. And nevertheless, it's still a great attraction, even for people who live here, because the variety of food and stuff going on, and then you've got this gym, old stove, on this patio, and also Pike Brewing Company, which is one of the classic brew pubs, and it was Charlie and Rose Finkel started it, of Merchant Duvin fame as well. The people who brought Orval to America, among other brands. And, you know, they have this vast collection of Berriana memorabilia. So, we had,
Lining the walls.
Beer there. Yes, you can still get a kilt lifter there. And I do want to have Andy Ingram on sometime to tell the story about how they had to settle with a couple breweries who had a kilt lifter in their name before they went out with their acquisition by ADI. But it's a great story. I don't know if he's said it anywhere on podcasts or anything, but maybe he has. So we need to see if we could book that sometime. This town was just, you know, nuts. And, you know, the Ubers were like through the roof, as you can imagine, the price on Uber on Sunday, Mother's Day. And the weather is just amazingly beautiful, sunny, you know, 75 degrees. So, yeah.
Wow.
So we ended up going to, Brenda is here at work, but she has cousins here, and we hung out with them. And we went to an Elks Lodge, the Ballard Elks Lodge. It's right on the Sound here. And they have a little beach, and we sat and drank Rainier's on the patio. So, yeah.
We, on Saturday, we continued our journey after the Ash meeting to Saltfire.
Saltfire
Tap Room. Stop by there. Got to meet your neighbor.
Eric?
No. Roseanne.
Rochelle.
So close. Long word, double N, starts with an R. Double consonant. I mean, yeah. So we went and saw Rochelle. That was great. Had some Saltfire beer. We actually shared one beer because we knew our time was short. Then, went and got our pedicure.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Because we were going to the beach, so we have to have a pedicure. And then we went to Bottle Shop. Had a grand old time there.
You know, there's a rumor that they're opening the place near my house. I don't know if we deal in rumors on the show at all.
What are you talking about?
The old Riazzi's Pizza, which was the Golden Pineapple, my understanding, or people tell me in the neighborhood that the people from Bottle Shop 48 are going to open that place up. And I said, well, that could happen, but there was a reason why that other place closed.
That's a lot of work.
Might need some work. So, who knows?
Hmm.
Yeah. And it's a... this is outside of the rumor that I just told you. Claptrap, but I mean, it'd be difficult to just put a beer bar in there. You probably need to address that it's more of a restaurant because it's built like a restaurant. Because there are tables that are not, you know, in the mix, right? They're off to the side, and that's really not how beer bars work as well. You know what I mean?
And a giant nobody space that is actually a kitchen.
Yeah, nobody wants to be relegated to a side area in a place where you're trying to meet people and hang out. A restaurant works, totally. Anyway.
People got to do things.
It's mere speculation. So, I mean, that's not to say that no one who runs a beer bar could do that. Obviously, it's not as easy as just slapping your name on the door.
Right.
So, Saltfire and Bottle Shop 48. And then you went home?
Yep. Yeah. Well, we had to do some grocery shopping and then we went home. Yeah.
Okay, and you had a lovely Mother's Day, I'm sure.
Indeed, we did. We went to the Hungry Monk.
Nice.
Met my mom and dad, and Margaret came in and met with us as well. And we had just a lovely breakfast. I had the coffee stout from Oso. That was delicious. Should we talk pricing, or is that against antitrust laws? It was $11.50 for a 12-ounce pour.
Wow.
It was Mother's Day, and I'm worth it.
Yeah, I had an $11 cider here yesterday. I went to the Shilling Tap Room, which is right near the Fremont Troll. If you're familiar with that area, or the Troll under the bridge. I just kind of happened by it as I was walking from point to point, and I had this delicious Basque style cider, which I believe there was a little bit of Brett in it or something, or at least it was very naturally fermented. Had a nice yeast character, but that was an $11 glass. Like, of all the ciders that I would look at and go, oh, that looks really good, and then all of a sudden I get, yeah, just take a shot.
Well, I did it knowing when I ordered it, so it was fine.
Yeah.
Everyone had a great time and then went back to the house. Margaret came over. Joe came over. We played some games. Yeah. I got an Oculus for my birthday, Rob. Oculus Quest 2 goggle thing.
So are you a chronic oculator or just...
I'm a chronic oculator. So I've messed with it a couple times.
Yeah.
I purchased... Well, games are expensive, by the way. I purchased I'm just going to sit here like this while I'm talking.
Yeah.
I purchased a program to help me refresh my Spanish skills before we go to Rocky Point.
Uh-huh.
It seems that's kind of foolish because everyone speaks English down there.
Yeah.
But I did take Spanish in high school and have had the opportunity throughout my career to use it, so it's not like I don't know it, but remembering some things and new things.
So having that thing on your face is going to help you speak Spanish better? Or?
It's kind of cool, honestly. Like, you go in and you pick up an object, and then you can say, you can use your different triggers. Oh, God, I lost my glasses for a second. You can use your little triggers, and they'll tell you what the word is, and it has speech recognition, and you can re-say it, and if you're using the correct word, the correct pronunciation and accent and all kinds of things, and it'll either check you off on knowing that word or not. And it's gamified with the more words you know, the more color comes back to the island, and then the people start coming back, and you can interact with them, but first you have to get your basic words down. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Cool. Well, so I'll just throw a few notes about what I did here on Monday, but today I'm meeting with Daniel from the Washington State Brewers. I don't know, the Guilder Association. Whatever. Mm. Those guys. The guys that do what we do.
All right.
I'm meeting with Daniel this afternoon at Stoop Brewing on Capitol Hill. And so I'll probably reference our discussion in a future episode, depending on what comes out of that. But I'm also here visiting, coincidentally, a friend of mine who has been in the brewing industry for a while. He suffered an accident, and I was hoping to see him, but I guess he's... doing okay, but not really able to see anybody. He's going to be out for 6 weeks. Had some sort of head injury and spinal fracture. So I'm meeting with his wife for probably dinner and drinks tonight as well. So.
Wow. That's rough.
Yeah. It sure is. So he's a you know, he's everything that you'd want in this industry in terms of, you know, knowing so many people, having so many connections, telling many stories. You know, was an owner of a brewery for a while, worked at several breweries, works with some of the very influential brewers here in Seattle. So hopefully everything's gonna be okay. And it, you know, I've known his wife for a long time too, so nice to catch up with her. But those are the things that are happening today. I'm going to ask the Washington Brewers Guild about their event coming up. They have a statewide festival here at the Seattle Center. I kind of want to, you know, as we have our changes in our industry with events, I kind of want to bend his ear a little bit about how that's going.
Yeah, so on that note, if anyone is thinking about getting a ticket to Real Wild and Woody Beer Fest, just go do it now. Like, why wait until 2 weeks from now? Just get it now.
Yeah, well, it looks like our VIPs, we might have to create a ticket of no parking VIP. Those are probably gone by the time.
Yes, yes. There's very few GA tickets sold, and everyone that bought a GA has been hitting me up to please upgrade me. I need to figure that out.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, so I think we might have to do that different kind of ticket. But we could talk about that offline. Yesterday, I ended my night later than I wanted to.
Shocking.
I went to I don't know if it's really a dive bar. It's considered a dive bar by some, but I went to this place called Hattie's Hat. And it has a long history. It's 120 years old, I think. It started out as kind of a supper club. And they still serve breakfast all day and lunch and dinner. They typically are open from 10 to 2 a.m. So they have craft beers there. They have obviously divey beers, and but you know, it's a food menu. It's kind of a rock and roll place. But last night, in the back room, there was a circle of bluegrass players that were just, they were performing. They were just jamming. They had been together for 2 or 3 years, and people came and people left. They would just go around the circle. And, you know, that person would pick a song, and they would flesh it out. It was good. They kind of waved me in, like, and so I was really the only person watching them the whole time. And it was just cool to see a different group of people collaborating, you know, like our industry, kind of. It just was a sort of, an analogy to what we're going through. And, you know, they were poking fun at each other. And it was just a great little scene. And, you know, like, to go somewhere on Monday night when a lot of restaurants are closed, after 9, have, you know, this full menu and eat a meatloaf and mashed potatoes and collard greens and then have a few beers and watch a bluegrass band. I mean, it's really cool.
Pretty solid, yeah.
So we got a train going by now.
Oh.
So my other big checkoff item, because I went to this brewery that had a sort of a captured sushi truck in sushi area, and you order off his kiosk. In my building is a pizza machine, like a vending machine. So I'm gonna get a late night vending machine pizza. I will try to.
All right, report back if you can. Sounds interesting. I mean, if you can just post one of those up in a brewery, all of a sudden there's a food solution for you. Right?
Yeah. I don't know. It seems like a clean solution, but who knows? It's in a hotel, so it's not like it's driving traffic, right? It's not like it's an attraction to. So it must be more utilitarian than just, you know, a gadgety sort of hype thing, you know? Like,
sure.
That's the kind of thing you put in somewhere to, you know, like if you're Las Vegas, you put in the automated robotic cocktail thing. No one knows what it is, and everybody walks by.
Everyone walks by, looks, and goes, ugh.
What the hell's that?
But hey, you got the pizza. That's a different thing.
Totally different.
Let's see.
Well,
I... talked to a chemical manufacturer as an allied member yesterday. Talked to some QA analytics, which is actually way more than that, more of a sanitation system kind of organization today. Putting together a newsletter. Got a lot going on. It's pretty great.
Yeah, yeah. And I've been working on our election documents and putting together an orientation for new nominees to spell out what next year is going to be. That's something that we haven't done. So we hope to spin up this new board that will be coming into effect in the summer very early. So I am working on that this afternoon. But I'll tell you what, man. Sun is shining. I'm probably going to order some food here. But I think we should just kind of cut this at the 35-minute mark or so, because it's going to take me a little bit more effort to upload this in a janky Wi-Fi situation than normally
yeah.
would. So
yeah.
I have to get your files. I have to get my files together. And, you know, I say I won't add a lot of stuff, but I already promised I was going to throw some pictures up and some B-roll. So why don't we just... say goodbye, and I'll spin you up on Daniel's conversation tomorrow, and we can see if that's worthy of another show, or we need to move on to the next week.
Cool.
Great.
All right, Rob. Well, have a good time there. Don't let the wind blow you away. I don't know what's going on. It's gorgeous, right? This is beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
I see people walking around with jackets. It's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I'm wearing the long sleeves and jacket just for because I can.
Exactly.
But I'll get with you later this afternoon.
All right. Hey, it's not a beer podcast. It's a podcast about beer. Mostly.
Got it. Sometimes the cider finds you too.
There you go.
All right.
Cheers.
Bye.